Wetland environments are characterized by clay-based soil, low oxygen, and excess water. The hydrophytes, or wetland vegetation, that grow in or near bodies of water have adapted to these conditions morphologically, anatomically, and physiologically. Obtaining oxygen is so important because when oxides of nitrogen, iron, and sulfur become reduced, it can be toxic to the plant. The roots, stems, and leaves of aquatic plants differ from their terrestrial counterparts. The roots are typically smaller, as water can diffuse directly into the leaves. Those partly or wholly submerged in water develop long, thin roots to increase buoyancy and for more flexibility when clay soil swells. Shallow water hydrophytes have pneumatophores, or upward-growing roots, to help obtain oxygen from the atmosphere. Terrestrial wetland plants have shallow root systems as well to obtain oxygen from the atmosphere. The stems of submerged hydrophytes have spongy tissues for buoyancy and large internal air spaces for oxygen storage and rooting in shallow water. Leaves of emergent plants are large and flat to aid flotation. They have a thin cuticle or waxy covering because they do not need to prevent water loss due to the well-saturated environment. The most important anatomical adaptation is the stomata, which enable gas and water exchange through pores in the leaves. Instead of being located under the leaf, they are located on top in aquatic plants to get oxygen from the air. They remain open for a majority of the time because of the abundance of water surrounding them. Many species grow in or near salty water, so they have developed excretory cells to eliminate or prohibit salt intake. Hydrophytes have changed their physical features to accommodate the low oxygen, clay soils, and salty environments they might inhabit.